Magandang buhay po sa inyong lahat. Ako po si Jennifer Lansang, single mom, working mom, and business mom. Isa rin po ako sa Primary 12 ni Pastora Vicky Valdez at kasama ko po ang aking mga anak na si Chef Felix Gayus. He's a chef and an instructor at Culinary Institute of Prima Deli at isa rin po siyang estudyante ng STI Tarlac taking up the SHM. Kasama din po natin ang aking anak na si Felix Eros who is a 2-year defending champion for table tennis sa entire province ng Tarlac at he is representing TFBC School. Our life story is like a roller coaster ride. Ang pinanghawakan po namin ay ang pangako ng Panginoon sa Isaiah 1:19 that if you are willing and obedient, you will eat the best from the land. Sa mga preaching ni Bishop sa mga nakaraang linggo po about Father Series, the Lord God have touched the heart of my sons.
Ang mga verses pong ito ay ang pinanghawakan namin ng kuya ko para po maayos ang relationship namin kay Dad. Sa Ephesians 6 verse 1 to 3, ang sinasabi po nito ay, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise, so that it may go well with you and that you may enjoy long life on earth."
At first, I was mad at my father. I was in anguish. I was mad. Like, wala akong thankfulness sa mga ginawa niya. He was trying so hard to apologize and he ended up hurting us. I ended up hurting him. And every single day, I never talked to him, even if he was providing for us. Even if every month he sends us allowance, he tries to communicate with us. His expression is very stern. One day, si Bishop Frank nag-discuss about sa forgiveness, which is I had in my heart for so many years. It's been about almost 10 years na tinatago ko yung pain na yun. Na pinaramdam ko sa kanya na I hate him, pinaramdam ko sa kanya na I don't want to forgive him. All my life, I tried to be successful. I tried to be someone. Pero it never really did me peace. Kasi unless you really forgive, that's when you start to reap the blessings. He was going to come over for my birthday. And before that, I've already forgave him through chat, which is something na parang gumaan sa loob niya, gumaan sa loob ko. And then he came home. Although may nangyari na ang half-brother ko is he got admitted in the hospital for an infection sa urine niya. He still came over. Inayos lang yung situation doon and then he came over. In 20 minutes, he was here sa Tarlac, from Pampanga to Tarlac. For me, that's a big thing. He tried to show na he cares for my emotion. He cares for my brother's emotions. He wanted to show na I am a good father, na you have forgiven me, therefore, I want to bless you back. Yun yung hiningi ko kay Lord ever since. Ever since I was in the music ministry, ever since I was there every day. I was fighting, I was praying, I was in cell group. So, what happened during that day? He came over, and then he was the most happiest that I have seen him in so many years. We were happy, all of us, we were enjoying. So we had dinner, we had lunch, and then the next day he came over again. And the most vital part of my birthday, kahit na nasa hospital kami, we were there, I saw my half-brother. He never knew me, pero I knew him. Pagka-step in ko sa room, he looked at me, kahit na meron siyang tatlong dextrose sa paa. He looked at me, and he was rolling over. At 4 months old, he was rolling over already. He was trying to look at me. He was trying to crawl to me. That meant a big part to me. Parang it melted me to my core na I'm a brother. I'm a big brother. And these are my little brothers. Although they're not with me, pero they look up to me. And that is because of what my dad did. He made me as an example. And therefore, I should be an example. My mom prepared a special birthday cake. Na even though I don't eat cake, I don't like sweets, they prepared me this beautiful cake na para siyang chef jacket, which meant so much to me. I don't really eat cake, pero I told my mom na that is the best cake I've ever had. It's because of the cherished moments na sama-sama kami, we are happy. Like, if you really forgive someone, if you really forgive your father, your mother, everyone, if you forgive, you will not remember anything anymore. Like, wala nang anguish, wala nang, hindi ka nagalit, wala ka nang sama ng loob. It's peace. we were enjoying even in a hospital. And then it hit me na uuwi na kami. So we're about to go home. Out of the blue, nakuha ko yung lakas na loob para magsalita. Yung sinabi ko kay dad ko, "Dad," sabi ko, "I have to say this to you before you go or before we go home to sleep. I want to say thank you sa lahat ng ginawa niyo. Sa lahat ng bawat araw na hindi niyo pinalampas, na hindi kami sinisigurado na provided kami, well cared kami. You always look out for us. And hindi ko nakita yon dahil ginagalit kita, na pinipiga kita, na lahat na lang ng ginawa ko ay mapasama ang loob mo." And then, ang sabi ko sa kanya, "Dad, I love you. Okay? I love you with my whole heart. Gusto kong sabihin sa iyo ito for so long na ngayon ko lang nakuha ang lakas para masabi talaga sa iyo." He did not say anything. Take note, if a man does not say anything, he's feeling something deep down inside na alam kong natutunaw na siya. He was brought to his core. And then ang sabi ko sa kanya, "Dad, sana huwag na masama ang loob mo sa akin. I inherited everything from you, from your skills, everything to your smarts, to your intellect. I have inherited that. I am proud to call you my father. And I'm so proud to be your son. I will honor your name," sabi ko sa kanya. "From this day on, Dad, I want you to always remember this. I love you and I'm proud of you. Thank you for making this birthday the best. Thank you for helping me live through this 20 years of my life na nandyan ka lagi to support us. I want you to protect us. I want you to help us." And he replied, "I will protect you and I will help you every single day as long as I'm alive." He said those words. And to me, that meant everything. To my brother, for them to have security, that's more than anything and anyone could ever ask for. That was the best gift ever. And then, bababa na kami, nandito na kami sa bahay. He hugged me. Bigla niya akong hinila sa shoulder. He hugged me the tightest that he could. And that's when you really feel na, I am whole again. I told the Lord to make me whole, to make me peaceful. Because I believe, you cannot be successful if something is dragging you down. You need to learn to forgive. When you learn to forgive, that's when you know that you really are successful. I teach, therefore, what I walk, I must talk. So that's what I did, and it encourages everyone. It's a happy story for me, and the best story I could ever tell.
Truly, God makes all things beautiful in His time. Forgiveness is the key to tear down the veil that is hindering your restoration. Sa mga nakaraan pong preaching ni Bishop, talagang pina-follow up kong aking mga anak. And I was crying out to them na, "Forgive your father because you don't know what he has been through." Their father grew up without a father. Yes, his physical father nandyan, pero hindi naging tatay ang ama niya sa kanya. Kaya lagi ko pong sinasabi sa kanila, you cannot put the blame to your father kasi siya rin wala siyang naging ama. Kaya po, every now and then, I always remind them na if you find that your father is not being a father to you, look up and you have a father in heaven that will embrace you, that will protect you, that will love you unconditionally. Kaya po, sa lahat ng mga kabataan na nandiyan at sa mga magulang din, lalo na sa mga single mom na katulad ko, napakasarap ng mga panahong itong nararanasan namin because we have experienced the real meaning of forgiveness and being forgiven. To God be the glory. Again, this is Jennifer,
Chef Felix,
Champ Felix,
and this is our champion's testimony.